No, Chris. Chris didn't make the trip. So, you know, Brett Swain will step in there for him, and, you know, it'll give opportunity for some other guys.
One of those guys is Alex Anthony. How do you think he's feeling heading into his first road trip?
You know, I think he'll be pretty good. He got some playing time last year, and it's good to see young guys step up and see what they have, you know, in case you have to need them when the games, you know, playoffs and things like that. So it's a good experience for him early in the year.
Darian spoke to the group afterwards. Can you tell us what he said?
The biggest thing he just talked about is opportunity. You know, we talked about, you know, that Toronto would be looking for a win and how, hey, we're looking for a win also. But just the opportunity for new guys to step in and do what they do and, you know, just take advantage of this opportunity.
How much of that did he do even last year? Address the team on a walkthrough?
Well, you know, each week we have someone different do it. But, you know, I try to rotate through Darian as much as possible. He is one of the leaders on this team, and it's always good to hear his voice and hear his mindset as the quarterback goes, as the team goes.
Individually, do you think at all that he wants more yards than Ricky Ray or more touchdown passes because of the Ricky was rated first in the league?
I think he just wants to be the best, and whatever it takes, you know, it may be yards or there, but at the end of the day, you know, when you talk to Darian and even Ricky, they just want that Grey Cup, and they probably just want to be the Grey Cup MVP or something like that. They want it all.
What do you think Sam Hurrell has to show you tomorrow's game after the way he started?
The biggest thing with Sam is he has to be disciplined in his reads and some of the defenses that we put in and tackle well. You know, that's what's going to make him be a stud in this league. If he can tackle well and run around, you know, he missed a couple of sacks last week. He could have had about 4 sacks, and that would have been like a lead for him. So, you know, nerves and all that played a part, but I think it'd be better this week.
Is that similar to the game you played in the CIS level, or covering from sideline to sideline when you saw when you drafted
him? You know, these guys are a lot faster than most guys in the CIS, but, you know, he has to get back to that to where he's comfortable. Once he gets to where he's comfortable, then I think he'll be good to go.
It's a good test for your team, the first real road trip of the year, the distractions of the road and everything.
I think, you know, the distractions of the road, you know, playing a Ricky Ray quarterback, playing a team that, you know, defensive staff that got up there is pretty good last year in Winnipeg. So there's a lot of different tests and a lot of things that can be answered this week.
Rob Bagg was fined for a play that none of us really saw on the field. What do you think of that?
keeps him humble. Yeah. He's a resident good guy. So every now and again, the good guy, it's life. But I didn't really see the play either, but I heard about it, and, you know, that's just part of it.
Seems like they're going to be watched a little more closer under the new director officially.
Yeah, there was a long list of guys that got fined for some things, and that's good. It keeps the game clean, and, you know, it keeps the guys in check.